When most people think about classical music, they think about fancy restaurants or rich people. And I'm here to change that. I haven't seen any classical music in the Billboard Top 100, and that's pissing me off. So without further ado, welcome to the Refrigerated Guide to the Beauty of Classical Music. The main argument I hear from people against it is that it's boring. And that's because you just see it as instruments playing notes. It's all about perspective. You could interpret it as pianos and violins making random noises, or you could look at it deeper. How I look at classical music is through storytelling. I find it so fascinating that composers can tell a story without even saying a word. To me, that's amazing. For example, one of my favorite pieces right now is Mozart's Piano Trio No. 6, and to me, it tells a clear story. In the first part, it's like a happy-go-lucky character galloping around the Victorian times roads, just enjoying life. And then he like goes into a store and the shopkeeper is having a conversation with him. And then he walks out the store and continues on his walk, where he encounters an obstacle. An obstacle that makes him question and ponder. He keeps walking, and then someone walks over to him and breaks terrible news. Or sometimes I envision it as three characters having a conversation. I can go on and on, but you get what I mean. And what I find the most beautiful about it is that it is entirely perceptual. Like the story I come up with is gonna be different from the one you come up with. Now let's turn the tables a whole 180. Gymnopédie number 1. Damn! I don't know what happened to Eric, but whenever I hear this song, I feel sad. Like the character is a middle-aged man with depression. Maybe his wife died. Maybe he doesn't see the joy in life anymore. Maybe he's just staring into the raindrops on his window, wondering when he's going to replicate them, falling downwards in such a minuscule and unimportant size that no one cares. Or maybe he's just having a chill day and relaxing by the pool. It's completely up to you. Gosh, I love the stories you make for music. Like, I know this is a hot take, but I prefer Dance of Knights to the Imperial March. I'm sorry, it's just personal preference. Like, if I'm training my army, I want them to march to this. That sounds so intimidating. Like, the Jedi's ain't gonna do none. I don't know what to call this. But this song hits, bro. Makes you feel like Tony Montana. Like, the world is yours. Like, when I think of the story, it's like someone who made it. They succeeded. and they sit on the balcony of their mansion, smoking a cigar, like, yeah, all my hard work paid off. I know this is kind of off topic, but I'm fully convinced that John Williams isn't a real person. You mean to tell me that he was the composer for Jurassic Park, Jaws, Indiana Jones, E.T., and Star Wars? And they're all bangers? Like, every single main theme has become iconic. Who do y'all think is the best composer? Chopin definitely has some underground bangers, and I really like his music. And Beethoven is a true G, like, come on now. Burrow dropped the hardest symphony and couldn't even hear it. He was deaf! He made music and he was deaf. Who can do it like Ludwig van? That's impressive. You gotta clap it up. Even if you don't like his music or the genre completely, you gotta respect that he made music without being able to hear. But we all know who the GOAT is. Mozart has one of the hottest discographies I've ever heard. I mean, what do you expect? He could play the piano at 4 and started composing at 5. Like, what? Sometimes I wish these people were still alive today. Like, imagine Beethoven and Youngboy collabed? Chill.